Okay, so now that we've used Beautiful Soup to parse this HTML so that we can extract the values we need to pass along in our post request, let's talk about why these values are here. Well, as many websites do, this particular data source uses these values to validate each request that comes in. And if you're really interested in specifically how, for example, view state is used, I'd encourage you to look in the ASP documentation to see how those types of servers use that particular type of value. Okay, so just in case it's not clear, what we have to do first is submit an initial request and then use the response that we get back, specifically the values for view state and event validation, in order to make any subsequent post requests. So let's take a look at the code. Now, one thing I want to point out, something I didn't mention last time, is that here we've actually hard-coded in the value for airport list and carrier list. But of course, what we'd be doing is actually looping through all possible combinations of values in our airport list and carrier list from the data that we extracted using this code. Okay, so in this code, we're making an initial GET request, parsing the response to get the view state and event validation, and then submitting a subsequent post request. Let's run it. Okay. Here we're writing this out to a file called virginandloganairport.html. Let's go take a look at that file. Here it is. And of course, we're going to lose the style information because the relative references will all be broken. We're not actually pulling down the CSS or the JavaScript files that are referenced in this HTML file. So instead of the data that we wanted, instead we're getting a syntax error. So we need to figure out what's going on there.